The crash happened as the Pakistan International Airlines flight was attempting to land for a second time. Initial reports say the Airbus pilots sent a mayday message reporting problems with both engines and made a go-around. A few minutes later, the airliner came down in a highly populated residential area near Karachi International Airport.
The last words we heard from the pilot was that there were technical problems. He was told on the final approach that both runways are ready and you can land. But the pilot decided he wanted to go round. For that reason, and what the technical problem was, we're going to go and look at that now.
Airplane parts were strewn among burning homes. Security forces were sent to help the rescue operation and managed to pull at least two passengers from the wreckage. Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan tweeted saying that he was shocked and saddened by the crash, offering prayers and condolences to the families of the dead. Aviation apps identified the aircraft as a 15-year-old Airbus A320. It was one of the first in PIA's fleet to restart flying this week after flights were grounded to stop the spread of the coronavirus. Crash investigators are expected to arrive to begin the search for clues and find out what went wrong on the relatively short flight of an hour and 45 minutes from Lahore to Karachi. The crash coincides with the end of Ramadan, normally a busy time for travelers returning home for their Eid holiday. It's also 4 years since another air crash in Pakistan during Ramadan killed all 47 people on board. Leah Harding, Al Jazeera.
Let's get the latest now from Kamal Haider in Islamabad. Kamal, what more do we know?
Well, we now know that there were 99 people on board. Earlier it was said that there were 98 people on board, and those two people, of course, being rescued, and that also by the first responders who were the locals in the area, after which the rescue teams arrived. But because this was a congested area with narrow alleyways leading to the site of the crash, that the military was then called in with the heavy equipment to try and cut access into that area. It is now nightfall. Rescue and relief efforts are still underway. Many people are trapped under the rubble, it is feared, and most of the people who have been turning up in hospital with serious injuries apparently are the people who were on the ground at the time of that crash. So investigators obviously now will be looking at what really happened in the final moments after that mayday signal, but it appears that the plane was in a gliding mode, which suggests that its engines had already gone, and probably that is one of the reasons. But investigators will have to find out the real cause. It is indeed a tragedy. This particular story is likely to remain for the next 12 to 13 hours because the rescue effort is going to be difficult. It is nighttime, it is Ramadan, and people will be working round the clock to see if anybody is buried under the rubble of those destroyed homes.
Thank you for that, Kamal Haider, there live from Islamabad.